गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग गुड. सो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट इकोनॉमिक इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ फंजाई टॉपिक फ्रॉम चैप्टर नंबर 9. सो व्हाट आर फंगी और फंजाई. सो फंजाई कम अकॉर्डिंग टू द 5 किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशंस. फंजाई आर नॉट प्लांट्स. दे आर नॉट प्लांट्स बिकॉज दे डू नॉट हैव. वाई दे आर नॉट प्लांट्स बिकॉज दे डू नॉट हैव क्लोरोफिल. सो दे हैव नो क्लोरोफिल एंड देयर मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन इज ऑल्सो हेट्रोट्रॉफिक. दे डू नॉट हैव ऑटोट्रॉफिक. दे डू नॉट शो द ऑटोट्रॉफिक न्यूट्रिशन लाइक प्लांट्स. सो आर एच विटेकर दैट गिव्स द और प्लेस्ड ऑल द फंजाई इन अ किंगडम नंबर 3 सेपरेट किंगडम. सो रिमेंबर दे डू नॉट हैव द क्लोरोफिल एंड दे आर नॉट प्लांट्स. So they do not have the root, stem, leaves, flower like differentiated plant parts. So they are more likely evolved as a eukaryotic organism and they have a true nucleus. They are multicellular also. So they have the true nucleus. That's why they are called eukaryotes, eukaryotic. So the most common fungi is molds, which can grow on food, which can grow on bread, fruit, or even the leather or bark of the trees. So two most common fungi are mushrooms and toadstools. So they are the common one and they can grow in a warm rainy season or warm or humid season. So most of the mushrooms are poisonous but some are edible. So what is mold? First fungi, which is the common one, is mold. So what is mold? What is the structure of the mold? So mold is the common bread mold. So in our bread, when the bread will get the humid environment or conditions, so these fungi or these mold grow on our bread. So mostly you have seen the white color or blackish or greenish color patches on the bread mold. They are molds. So bread mold is also called as rhizopus. So the biological name is rhizopus. So it grows, this rhizopus, which is a bread mold, it grows not only on bread but other organic matter also, like fruit, animal dung, leather goods, whenever they will get the warm and humid climate. So remember the conditions. Now what is their structure? So it consists of a network, thread like transparent network structures. That network is called hyphae. So this hyphae, all the hyphae or the entire mass of the hyphae or the thread is called mycelium. So remember these two terms, hyphae, it is a thread like structure, and the total thread like structure is called mycelium. So this hyphae, what is the function of it? It digests the, it secretes the certain enzyme which digests the outer this layer, which is called of bread, it is called bread substratum. So this it digests the bread substratum layer and it absorbs it. So you can see in this circular diagram, in this magnifying diagram, so here they are showing the hyphae also and they are showing the thread like structure, the entire one, mycelium also. Now you can see it is a branch like structure and it from this hyphae only sporangiospore arise, which spore, this is sporangiophore, this tube like structure then give this cup like structure which is called sporangium. So you can see this cup like structure, it is called sporangium, and in this sporangium only spores are present. Spores are filled inside the sporangium, which is attached to the sporangiophore with the hyphae. So this structure is very important and it is very clear also. So whenever the spore get the favorable condition, the cell wall of the sporangiophore break down or it get rupture and all the spores bust out and disperse far off places. So this is all about. So you can see the in the C diagram they are showing the spores also. A sporangiospore bursting to release spores. So what is the reproduction? So reproduction wise they follow the both ways, asexual also and sexual also. Asexual reproduction starts within a few days of the growth of mycelium, some hyphae become erect. Erect means straight. So you can see here, these are the erect one. They are the straight one. So they become straight, erect, and they are called sporangiophore. Sporangiophore have the swollen part, that is called sporangium, and when it turns dark, so thus it means the dark color of the sporangium means the spores become mature inside it. Now the sporangiophore burst to liberate spores, which is scattered through the wind, and whenever they will get the favorable conditions or like substratum, like you know, if the bread piece is there near that, so their spores will germinate. They need only warmth and moisture, and they will form new mycelium. So this is about bread mold, which is called rhizopus. Now so they can grow anywhere, they can grow on the so next one is the yeast is also another fungi. So yeast is generally in a separate spherical cell, so it is shape is spherical. You can see here figure 9.7, yeast structure is spherical. So it has the glycogen granule, vacuole, also fat vacuole, cytoplasm, cell wall and nucleus. So this yeast, they belong to the genus Saccharomyces. So they belong to the genus Saccharomyces. So all yeast are one-celled fungi. They occur either singly or in the budding chain or in a chain. So where they are found mostly in the atmosphere, in the air, and they grow readily in the all sugary solutions. So in the sugar syrup, in the plant excretion, in the plant syrup, like few plant they excrete the sugar syrups, they have the nectar, so they can easily grow. Yeast can grow on the plant these nectars. They grow readily on grape juices, also in the nectar of the flower, in the sugarcane juice, anything. So you can underline this line. Now what is the structure? I told you they are ovoid in shape. You can see here, some are spherical in shape. They have a distinct cell wall, so you can see here, and they have either one or more vacuole also in the cytoplasm. So how they take nutrition? So yeast can directly absorb simple sugar, but they can and even the cane sugar. They just cane sugar is called sucrose. So they break down the sucrose into the glucose, and then they absorb it. How they respire? So yeast always respire anaerobically. They do not need oxygen. So without using oxygen or in the absence of air, they respire aerobically. And when they respire, they form ethyl alcohol, ethanol, CO2, and they will release 2 ATP. So this is a reaction I have explained you in the class 8 and 7 also about the aerobic and anaerobic respiration. So what is the importance of yeast? So yeast plays a very important role because yeast is very widely used in the alcoholic fermentation process, because yeast has the ability to ferment the and manufacture the ethanol. So the alcohol ethanol produced is of great commercial use, people are using. So when produced, it is used in beverages, and the quality of the alcohol also varies with the fermented material or the kind of yeast they are using at large scale industries. So useful and harmful fungi. So some fungi are very useful. As we all know, the penicillium is a fungi which penicillium is an antibiotic. Okay, so several species of penicillium which are produced by fine flavored cheese. So this is used for the production of cheese also, flavored cheese also. And this Penicillium notatum, it is also a very good species of fungi, and from this species only Alexander Fleming discovered of the first antibiotic, which is called penicillin. Now most fungi are harmful because they spoil our food, they can damage even the forest trees. So there are two fungi, Penicillium and Aspergillus. They are the common one, and they are also called as blue mold or green mold. So they grow on fruits like oranges, lemons. They can easily grow on the citrus fruit. They cause the diseases like ringworms. So you can see in the picture also, this green patch is a fungus. Now how this, what is the structure? So you can see the green is fungus growing on the outer screen of the rotting lemons or this. So this is the fungus. So they are also having, here in the figure 9.8, they are showing the structure of the Penicillium. They are also having the hyphae. They are also having the sporangiophore. Now, what are the useful? So useful is, they are very useful for the production of the antibiotics. So an antibiotic is a chemical substance produced by a living microorganism which can stop the growth or kill other microorganisms. So the first antibiotic was Penicillium, which is produced as a mold. So you can underline this line, and it is discovered by Alexander Fleming. So what is the criteria for choosing a good antibiotic? First criteria that scientists used, there are three main. First, it should kill a wide variety. Whenever they are preparing any antibiotic, they keep one thing in mind, that it should kill high or more variety of the disease or bacteria or fungi. So it should be able to kill a wide variety of diseases also, and like its spectrum should be broad. Second one, it should not produce any undesirable side effect. It should not produce any side effect. It should not kill normal bacteria also, because you know in our body we have so many bacteria. So it should not kill our normal bacteria, otherwise we will get diseased. Now what are the other uses of antibiotics? First one is, antibiotics are also used as food preservative, for preserving fresh meat and fish. It is also used for treating animal feed. So animal related diseases related to the fodder and feed, fodder and all. Now for controlling the plant pathogen, we can also use the antibiotics. Now fungi role in industry, in the large industry, is very high, because and it is very quiet and traditional method. So wine, people are making wine for this fermentation process. So what is fermentation? So fermentation is a process, you can underline or you can mark this box, that blue box. Fermentation is a process in which the microorganism like bacteria or yeast break down carbohydrate. So they convert carbohydrate into alcohol, which is also called ethanol or lactic acid, in the anaerobically, so in the absence of oxygen. So one reaction is also given, that glucose biochemical reaction. You can underline in a rectangular box, you can underline that glucose aerobically, by the action of yeast, get converted into ethanol and CO2, plus it will release 2 ATP. So the source for making wine in grapes or for beer is the microorganism. So yeast, which is also called as Saccharomyces cerevisiae, you can underline this line. This is the biological name of the yeast, one of the species of the yeast, Saccharomyces cerevisiae. So this Saccharomyces cerevisiae convert simpler glucose into alcohol. Now it is used in the baking industries also, for making bread making. It is used in the cheese making also. So curdling of the milk for making a cottage cheese and processed cheese. It is also used for salting method, in which we are just adding high amount of salt to kill the germs, to remove the undesirable microorganism. So for cheese industries, it is widely used. Then ripening. So the curd, when we will remove all the, well, we will keep it at a temperature, suitable temperature and humidity. So bacteria can the bacteria added along with the lactic acid bacteria. So it we can change the flavor of the cheese also by using the fungi. So like this, all these, this mushroom cultivation is not, it is an extra part. So for the mushroom cultivation in India, there are three kinds of mushrooms which we are widely cultivated in India. First one is white button mushroom, which is called Agaricus bisporus. Second one is paddy straw mushroom, Wolvericea, and the oyster mushroom, Pleurotus. So this mushroom cultivation can be done either in indoor or at outdoor also. So for this we need a substrate, we need a compost bed. So how we can make a compost bed? So we can make a compost bed by using the dead decaying organic matter. So for the white button, we need these five major steps. First one is composting, spawning, caching, cropping and harvesting and preservation. So first one is composting. Composting is a method through which we can prepare the substrate bed so that mushroom will get the all the favorable condition for their growth. So for making the compost or compost bed, we need white or paddy straw. We need chicken manure, organic or inorganic fertilizer, and we will give temperature to 50 degrees Celsius for 1 week. Then we have to add, in the second step, we have is spawning. We have to introduce the mushroom seed into this compost, and we have to allow to spread for a couple of days or a week. Then next third step is casing. In this we will just spread a thin layer of soil over the compost, and it is very important step because it gives support to the mushroom. It provides humidity, it provides quick drying, it helps to regulate temperature also. And what is the precaution we have to keep in mind during cultivation of mushroom? First one is we have to circulate the air around the bed so that seed will get the sufficient air for the growth, and we have to keep maintain the temperature also so that it should not be low, otherwise what will happen, the pest or pest will grow and it will spoil the seed also. Next is the fourth one is the cropping and harvesting step. So when the mycelium reached up to the 2 to 6, and we will see the pin head or button stage when it reach. You can see this picture, cultivated button mushroom they are showing. So at this button stage, when it become bigger in size or when they become fully grown, then we should harvest them. And then we know that mushrooms are highly perishable, they can be spoiled easily, they can damage. So we should preserve it under vacuum cooling. We should provide keep under the container which has gamma radiation, and we can store it at 15 degrees Celsius. We can do the freeze drying also under the citric acid, ascorbic acid and brine. Brine is a salt solution, high amount of salt solution. So these are the five steps. What is the need of mushroom? Why we are eating mushroom? Because it contain a high variety of nutrition. So mushrooms are excellent source of vitamins and minerals. So they contain a very good amount of niacin, pantothenic acid, biotin. All these are the vitamins and minerals. So the vitamins and mushroom, they are just retained even though we just cook them over, even though we can cook them, even though we will keep it under the high preservative material canning, and even we have dried it. In the all the three cases, their vitamins and minerals will not get damaged. They can retain their quantity. So fresh mushroom contain, the composition is given, the fresh mushroom contain 85 to 95% of moisture, 3% of protein, 4% of carbohydrate, 0.3 to 0.4% of fat, and 1% of minerals and vitamins. So this is the composition of protein. So remember, this is all about. So in our homework, please do the progress check activity and start doing the exercises. So thank you, children, and have a nice day. God bless you all.